When you think about solar power or just electricity in general, most people, including myself, used to think it was very confusing and really, really daunting. You got volts, amps, watts, input, output, AC, DC, storage, 120, 240. There's a ton of shit to know, but it's actually not as confusing as you might think. And when it comes to solar power and understanding what all these people are talking about when they're making videos on the internet or just trying to size or buy a system for yourself, a basic understanding of just a few simple terms and concepts is all you really need to know. So what's up, guys? Welcome back to the lab. Today we are in the first video of a short playlist of solar power for beginners. We're going to try and hit you guys with some really quick informational videos, with the end goal being for you to understand the basics of solar power and electricity and ultimately be able to appropriately size and get your own solar power system, whether that's a full traditional system or even just a small portable power station. If you're trying to understand what is going on in this world, you're in the right place. And when it comes to terms, we're going to go over all of the foundational ones that you need to understand that will make everything moving forward make a whole lot more sense. But the most important thing that you need to know if you are looking at any sort of solar power system is watts. And I think the easiest way to make any of this make sense is to picture a faucet and a hose on the outside of your house. You have a faucet on the outside of your house, and sitting with pressure waiting to go inside of that faucet is volts. And volts aren't something that you're gonna have to worry about a lot. They're pretty standardized. A house has 120 or 240 volts, which is just two strands of 120. And a car and a boat and that kind of stuff usually runs off a lower 12 volt system. But regardless, when you turn this faucet on, you allow 120 volts to start flowing out the end. So the water leaves there and starts flowing into a hose. And the hose represents amps. If you have a thin, very tiny hose, you're not gonna allow as much water to flow through. And if you have a really big, thick hose, you're gonna allow a ton more water to start flowing through this hose and eventually into the bucket. So in this example, the amps is represented by the thickness of your hose. And the most important part is right here at the end, what is coming out of your hose. So once you turn this on, you have 120 volts of pressure coming out. And then depending on how big of a hose you have, how many amps it has, will determine how fast this bucket fills up with water. As this bucket starts to fill with water, what you're getting is watts. And that's it. It is super simple. Now you might also be wondering, what is 240 volts? Because a lot of like bigger equipment and tools run off 240. 240 is this, but there's two faucets, two hoses, and they're both running into the same bucket to get you more power. And so the most important thing from all of this is that you need to understand watts. Inverters, battery banks, solar panels, everything is sized in watts. And typically devices in your house, like your fridge or your freezer, your vacuum, anything that you might want to power within your house doesn't always say how many watts it takes. And so you can actually find this really, really easy by doing volts times amps. And this right here is the most important thing that you could learn on the internet when it comes to solar power. Volts times amps equals watts. So if you have a vacuum that plugs into the wall, it'll say on it somewhere how many volts and how many amps it takes. I think almost every single thing that plugs into the wall has to have a sticker on it saying what it takes. And all you gotta do is take the fact that the vacuum's 120 volts, multiply it by the 15 amps that it's rated for, which is quite a lot for a vacuum, is equal to 1800 watts. And that is not only the messiest writing that you've seen today, but the most important writing. And you can do that with anything in your house, from laptops to your fridge to your camera batteries, whatever. The point is, everything in this industry is measured in watts, and you need to know how many watts all of your appliances and stuff takes. And most of them don't say, so you just need to do simple volts times amps equals watts. What are watts? Watts is actually so simple. You can basically think of it like an hourly measurement, like kilometers per hour or miles per hour. Watts is measured per hour. If something says it uses 1000 watts, it's gonna use 1000 watts over the period of 1 hour. If you run that device for 30 minutes, it's actually only gonna take 500 watts from the battery bank that it's plugged into. Super simple. And you might also hear kilowatt hours. And basically that is thousands of watt hours. Once things such as batteries start getting really, really big, they start measuring them in kilowatt hours. So the average house in the US uses 30 kilowatt hours of electricity a day. It's just a shorter way to write down 30,000 watt hours. Next up, you're gonna hear the terms AC and DC a lot. These are two different types of current. So DC is direct current. This is typically found in more low voltage things like a 12 volt car battery. Any kind of electronics prefers DC over AC. And DC means it's a direct current. So if you picture water going through a hose, the water is flowing through in a direction. That's how the electricity travels in a direct current system. You could basically imagine it similarly to how it would be hooked up in a car. You're gonna have your red cable connected to the positive, your black cable connected to the negative, and then you would have a device in between here. Power is gonna run up through this cable, it's gonna run through your device, back down into the battery in a single motion. It's gonna go up, through, and back down. That's a direct current. And this is really important because DC current is what solar panels produce and most of the way that batteries actually store power. So this right here is a 12 volt battery and it's gonna give you DC current, which is why eventually we'll get into it, you're gonna need an inverter. Alternating current typically doesn't have a positive and a negative. AC or alternating current is what comes into your house from the grid, like the power lines on the street. Every 120 volt wall outlet in your house and device you have in your house is running off of alternating current. Kind of like a little gun shooting ripples up each one. And so instead of the power flowing up through this and then back down into this one, what it's actually doing is sending tiny little shock waves up each one. And you can picture it more like a wave in the ocean. So if you're picturing this like water flowing through a hose in a straight line, you're gonna picture alternating current like a wave in the ocean. A wave doesn't really take the water anywhere. A wave is just like a force that travels through the ocean. The water rises up and comes back down, but it never actually moves. It just stays right there. The wave moves through the water. That's what alternating current is like. Some other terms you're gonna hear are inverter. An inverter's job is basically to take direct current and change it over to alternating current. Like I said, solar panels produce DC, batteries store it in DC, but most devices in your house want ACs. It could also take AC and turn it to DC, but in terms of a solar power system, you're likely gonna have it going from DC to AC. Another term you're gonna hear a lot is storage, and storage just refers to your battery capacity. So whether you have one battery with a 2000 watt capacity, or you have three batteries that total in at 6,000 watts of capacity. When someone asks about your storage, they're just talking about the total battery capacity that you have available. You're also gonna hear the words PV, and that just means solar. Sometimes different inverters or portable power stations will have their solar input labeled as a PV input. PV is basically the process of how a solar panel actually takes sun energy and turns it into direct current. It doesn't really matter when you hear PV or PV input or anything like that. PV equals solar. And you're also probably going to hear the word array. An array is basically your total amount of solar panels. So if you have four 100 watt solar panels, your array size is 400 watts. These should be the foundational fundamental terms that you need to know and give you a good head start going forwards, and hopefully just help you to understand the rest of what we have coming in this playlist for you guys. And that is all we got for you guys in this first video. So I will catch you guys in the next one. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you found value in this, send it to people, share this with your friends. Let's help more people understand this technology that can actually better our lives. And I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out and stay charged.